a very important issue is an occasional patient asking you how he will be able to count the number of grafts during the procedure so that he doesn't feel cheated. Though this is a trust issue that should not arise, but the patient is very much within his rights to ask for it. Something like buying vegetables by weight at the grocery store. After all, it is a commodity that is being sold and the cost is per graft. You can ask the clinic one day before to keep grafts for you to count. So if the clinic has enough petri dishes, they can keep 200 grafts in each petri dish. It is very simple to count 200 grafts. So if you have, say, about 4,000 grafts, you keep these 4,000 grafts in 20 petri dishes. The patient at random selects one or two petri dishes and counts the grafts, and he is satisfied if the count is correct. He need not count all the petri dishes and he will be happy. This allays the suspicion of the patient that there has been something amiss, that he has been cheated in the number of grafts. The other way to count the number of grafts that you're going to get is to count the number of slits. Every time the doctor makes a slit is one graft that will go in. And at the end of the procedure, you can see that no slit is empty. But this will not prevent cheating, because some unethical clinics will still divide the grafts into ones and put them, fill up all the slits. So when you are up against an unethical clinic, there is no way you can keep count. The third and quite a useful way is to use a software. The CAM Studio is an open source screencasting program for Microsoft Windows, released as free software. The software renders videos in an AVI format. It can also convert these AVIs into flash video format embedded in SWF files. Counting grafts is not enough. It is the grown grafts that should be counted, and this can be done using the same software after trimming your hair to number one size.